I love the fact that I'm free now. I got a freedom to like do whatever I want whenever I like. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, it's nice.
I'm Tinea Taylor. This is the Kiss Hype Chart, and tonight's conversation is a little bit different to the usual. I wanted to have some of my Kiss family join me on the show alongside the man of the moment. So let's welcome Juls from Kiss Night, Henrie from Kiss Fresh. I love that everyone just clapped for them. How are you, Big Mike?
I'm all right, man. How are you guys?
Good. Yeah. Welcome to the show for the very first time.
Thank you for having me.
We had to
is this
on.
My first time?
First time.
Is it?
Never come
I feel
here
like
before.
I've been here before.
Not for me.
Is it? No. It's because I know you all, innit?
Yeah.
So it's like, ah, yeah, link up.
He normally sees me when I've had 10 G&Ts. Do you feel like you can finally breathe now that the album is out, people are loving it? How do you feel?
I just feel happy. I feel really happy.
Good.
I feel like, it's weird. I was talking to Heidi and Bri earlier, and I feel like the first two times I dropped an album, I don't know, there's like a nervousness and like a tension that when you drop it and you're like, you're kind of like waiting for something to fall from the sky to like validate how you feel. Like,
yeah.
Just like, oh, I've released this album. But this time I'm just happy. I'm just content. I'm at peace. I'm quite joyful. I feel good. I thank God. Yeah, I'm all good, man. Yeah.
Amazing. There are a lot of great features on the album, and you highlighted like everyone and all of them in the Castles video on Instagram. Tell me, how did you get the legendary Grammy Award winning Queen India Ari on the album?
Listen.
When I saw you hold the picture, I was like, he's lying.
Yeah.
There's no way.
That was like, firstly, like, I remember, we hit her up, like, obviously through like Twin, the label, hit up like her people, and then Twin hit me and was like, yo, like she wants to do it, she's interested, like, here's her number. And I was like, oh, because you see approaching someone so legendary, it's so nerve-wracking, it's like, hello, Miss Ari. Like, you just got to be, like, it's just like, you can't
she
just, it's not
Miss
like,
Ari.
Yo,
yeah,
like,
yeah,
where's
yeah.
that verse at?
Yeah.
Like, it's like, yo, you got to approach
her. Did you want to call her auntie?
Like, listen, I just wanted to just be as respectful and polite as possible. Yeah. And I hit her and I said, no, she hit me first. Did I text her? No, she texted me first and was like, hi, like, really politely sent a verse. No, hi, like, is this Stormzy, by the way? No. Like,
I love that.
Just hit me back, you know, I've got the song, no. And I hit her and I was like, oh my God, like, I probably said, oh my God, like 10 times, like, oh my God. firstly, thank you for even considering this, no. And I was really, really just falling over my words. And then she just sent a voice note back, and it was so beautiful and so graceful. She was like, so I've heard the song, I really love the song, you know, can I change this lyric, but she was very like, can I change this lyric however, I know it's your story, so if you want to keep the lyric the same, that's fine. I can also sing it in this register, or I can sing it here, you know, or we can blend the two. You let me know. It's your story. It's your album. I'm at service to you. I'm at service to the
that.
Art.
Yeah,
and
nice.
I was like,
yeah.
And I'm like, yo, like, but India, that's a legendary, iconic, GOAT. One of the greatest artists of all time.
Yeah.
One of the most beautiful voices of all time. One of, like, just a musician and a true artist.
Yeah.
And like, for her to come into the process and be like, yo, I'm at service to your art, like. Mm. And like, I was like, okay, Miss Ari, like, okay, well, could
it's
you...
It's the miss for me.
I was like could you sing it high and then, you know, sing it low and maybe we blend the two, but it's just so, like, so graceful and so amazing. And for her to bring her, like, it was, and she was the final piece of the whole album, the final verse, the final thing. So it was just such a beautiful ending to have like the most legendary artist come on and bless the album and complete it. It was just, it was a dream come true. So God bless India. I haven't met her yet, but
soon come.
I've told her 1,000 times, when I see you, I am going to hug you and like, let you know how much you mean to me. So yeah, God bless her.
And then you can add that selfie to your album.
100%. Fanboy Mike, you already know. Come on.
I've asked Henrie and Juls to join us this evening because in some way I feel like they both played a part in the creative process of the album.
Yeah.
Let's start with Juls. My boy, you produced the track Need You on the album.
Jeez.
Stormzy, is Juls as laid back to work with as he is in real life? I always say Juls is like the most chilled out person I know.
Yeah, but I think that's, I don't know, I don't want to speak on his behalf, but
yeah,
I think that's his superpower, innit? Like, in terms of, you can hear it in his sounds as well. You can hear it in his music. You can hear it in his sonic. Like, I think his who he is and his character shines in his music. But that song, oh man, like, I remember that day. So Juls came to the camp that we done in OC Island, and then later on made Need You. Then I remember Juls was in the other room with Progression and the instrumentalist. Yeah, yeah. And I was in the, I can't remember what I was recording in the other room. And I've come in, he's been producing all day, and I've come in at the end and I've listened to it, and I remember the feeling. Because I remember I was sat there and Juls is just on the decks, like, and I'm sat there like, cuz, you know, you've taken this song from like here to here, like, just, he just Juls'd it. He just Juls'd it. And credit to him, because Twin always, like, when Twin speaks about, you've never heard him speak about you, because of course it's you and you won't be in the room, but when Twin speaks about Juls, he's like, Juls has like, he can't even describe it. He's like, there's just a sound. There's just a thing that Juls has, like, and he brought that to Need You, and blood, he took the rhythm from here to there, like. And I remember saying, like, so there's a saxophone on it. Is it saxophone? And I was like, that saxophone's crying, man. That saxophone ain't saying a word or a lyric, but I hear it. It's just talking to hear. Like, so credit to Juls, man. He's a legend, man.
How was that session for you, Juls?
Oh man, first of all, even the whole experience on the island.
Yeah.
Just with all of these great producers, Owen Cutts, Progression, Jacob Collier, P2J.
Yeah.
It was just like a whole family coming together, making like music, and everybody sharing ideas, and you never know what to expect, because sometimes those things can be intimidating. But it was like, you've gone to your homeboy's house to chill. And you know, shout out to P2J and Tempo and Progression, and you know, Sonzy and Sheila, that we worked on Need You together. Like, that song is so spiritual. I played it in the club on Friday.
Hard.
It was cold. That record is just, yeah, it's mind-blowing. I could go on and on about it, but it's just like...
And I can't believe it's my song. Like, I can't believe that. Like, that's think about it. I could have heard Juls on that rhythm. That could have been a Juls song or a Tendai song or someone else's song, P2, and I would have loved it. And I would have thought, oh, that's cold. But I would never think, yo, like,
that's Storms.
So I'm so happy, man. So I'm really happy. Yeah, I'm proud of that one, man. Proper. Yeah.
And big up Tendai as well, because Tendai, amazing artist, like...
Bad boy. Tendai's a bad boy, man. That you, like, even... sometimes I feel like he don't even understand what he done in it. Like for me, like, the lyric, the vocal, the confidence of it, like... And Tendai's... How old's Tendai? 20, 21, 22? No more than 22, like. He's a young man, like. And he approaches that rhythm with so much finesse, so much confidence, marry a melody with a lyric. Bad boy. Yeah, man. And we all came together. So shout out Juls, Progression, Tendai, P2J, Tempo, Aura Star, who came on at the end and done it. Like, it's, yeah, man. Come on, man. Need You, man.
Henrie, doesn't this make you want to be more talented?
No, honestly. I could just jump in the studio right now, to be honest.
Lay a quick one, innit? We'll do it. I knew from hearing, like, Hide and Seek and Fire Babe, that we were going to get vocals from you, Stormzy, on this album. Was there, like, any worry or apprehension on your part that people wouldn't take in this version of you?
Nah. I didn't worry. I just thought, yo, you gonna get these vocals, man. Yeah, like, as in, and I understand that, like, people might not want that from me, or might not like it from me, or might not expect it from me. But I was like, I'm not too bothered by that. Like, I just got to do what feels right. And I was, yeah, man. I've been singing, but I think this time around, I'm saying, yo, like, I'm gonna double down on it. So yeah, I wasn't worried at all. I think I was more. I don't know, maybe there's something in me that kind of thrives in the face of, like...
adversity.
Yeah. You know, like, as in, what? As in, you lot think, all right, cool, like... there's something between me and God. I know there's something powerful in, like, standing on a stage and people throwing tomatoes at you when you know you're doing something right. You know, like, as in, whatever you're doing, like, if I knew, I know what I'm doing is cold, I know it's beautiful, I know it's what I'm meant to be doing... So if I stand on the stage and I sing and people throw tomorrow and say, you're rubbish, get off, I'm fine with that. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Because I know there's reward in that.
Yeah.
I'm fine with it, yeah.
You're like, I'm good. I'm good.
I'm good, yeah, yeah.
Henrie, I asked you to join us on the show this evening because somebody had a famous cameo in the Mel Made Me Do It video. Is that now, like, Your claim to fame.
It's my thing, I'm not going to lie. I walk into my mum's house now, everybody looks at me different. Hey. No, it was a great time. Thank you so much for allowing me to be a part of that. And the story, I'm not going to lie, every single time I tell the story, people are like, there's no way you said that to Stormzy. There's no way.
Tell us.
So basically, we were in a party for a friend's birthday and I came down, I just sat next to Stormzy to say, hey, whatever. He goes, Henry, I'm not going to lie, I'm going to shout you for something. I'm going to shout you. I was like, a true Nigerian auntie, whether you shout me, whether you don't shout me, that's your business. That's your problem. Like, yeah, whatever, whatever. He's like, you watch, yeah. And then I actually got on the set, and of course, everyone's in white, and then you just see one tall figure, and literally just everyone's just watching him, like, walk by. I'm like, oh my gosh, he's definitely going to bring this up. And he did. He's like, you thought I was jebbing it, didn't you? I was like, yeah, I really did. I thought that you were joking. But it was a great thing to be a part of. And even walking on set and seeing everyone that I work with, that I know, even legends as well, like, it was very special.
Yeah, it was special.
I'm not going to sit here and ask why I wasn't in the right? Even though I have my white bag and my white shoe and my white dress ready.
Everybody was tweeting that. Like, people were actually saying, please, I have my white shoe at
my
home.
White shoe is by the door. But my boy Juls is on the album. And like...
Next time around, forget these though. I'm just gonna next time around, forget, we're gonna do something. We're gonna do a little something. No, but Juls is on the album. His album video. We're gonna we'll do a next thing.
Just my show. I'm just the outsider. Fuming. Juls, you must have heard the album way before the rest of us. I'm gonna put you on the spot now. But what was your first impressions?
Oh, when the camp started, there was this thing where they prayed every day before we're gonna get into the sessions, and Storms was like, I want to be free. And a lot of the songs that I was hearing, from Fire and Water to a few others, were sounding very spiritual. So I knew this was the type of album where he was going to be like unapologetically free and wants to express what's on his mind, what he wants to say, which is not really what a lot of rappers, especially from the UK, do. People probably expect the art. You know, we want Storms to come and spit and do some, you know, grime rhythm or something like that. But no, it wasn't like that. And to me, I liked that because he was actually telling a story about him and how he feels. And then sometimes you want to know that because it's kind of like you have a personal relationship with the artist as well. So that was my first impression of that album. So that's what I was excited to hear.
Henry, what's your favourite track?
My favourite song from the project is Holy Spirit.
Okay,
I really just like love the fact that faith is a foundation. Mm. Every single time we hear you speak, we hear you talk. I saw you in Ghana, do you remember? I saw you at the Citizen Global City. So I saw Stormzy in Ghana. Let me tell the story.
We get it.
Yeah. And he went up on stage and he just said something that I just thought was so profound, especially like being a person of faith as well. He was like, oh, I just want to take this time to actually just appreciate God. Do you know what I mean? I went to church like the next week and I was like, I just think it's incredible that you get to be so free in who you are and in, do you know what I mean? And what you believe. It's like, do you know what I mean? It's something that I would like to aspire to. So from he said that, I was like, yep, God, I know what I'm going to be doing. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, I know the kind of person that I want to be. Seeing somebody else do it, it's like, yeah, so can I.
There's so many different styles, I think, to Storms on the album. My personal is, this is what I mean. I love rap.
Cold rhythm.
Yeah, of course.
Grease mode.
Yeah. I like when you're a little bit arrogant. Yeah. Like right now, I'm like, cuss me out.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Get on the track and cuss me out. So my pink top is dead. But that's probably my favourite, you like bars.
Yeah. I
love Holy Spirit. Well. I love when you give us melodies, but it just takes me back to the beginning.
I hate, and that's the thing that like I enjoy about my career. Like even before I used to get, I don't know what's the word, I used to feel like there's people who really want singing Storms or really want bar Storms, and I used to feel like, but now I love the fact that there's people who appreciate different sides, and there's people who appreciate both. There's some people who say, yo, I'm tired of you singing, man, I want you to rap. There's some people who say, yo, you like, I got a good friend who always says to me like, yo, I love singing Storms, like, and I love the fact that like I'm an artist now who in whatever I feel, people will appreciate it. Do you know what I mean? Like, so if I'm ready to bar, that you're going to love it. If I'm ready to sing my gospel rhythm, you're going to, do you know what I mean? So I just love the fact that I love the fact that I'm free now. I got a freedom to like do whatever I want whenever I like. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, it's nice.
You have a lot of famous and talented friends. Who has given you like your favourite response to the album so far? What did Adele say? Was she like, love it, Stormzy?
No, I ain't spoke to her about the album yet. Nah, I ain't spoke to her. She's probably really busy with the phenomenal Vegas show. Yeah. Who have I spoken to? Ed FaceTimed me last night. And
Cash.
Yeah. Like that's my family though. Like, and yeah, he heard some of it from before like it got released. And yeah, man. And he's always really honest, like, and he said, like, yo, it was just really beautiful and moving. Yeah, but I'm trying to think who else hit me up. Dave, my brother, that's family. All these people are family though, don't even feel like that artist, like Dave just hit me and encouraged me and said, yeah, like you've done it.
Chris Martin?
Chris ain't hit me yet. No, Chris ain't hit me yet. But Chris is someone who I was gonna send it to him before it dropped, but I got so tied up in the overwhelmingness of an album release. But he's someone I always like. When I made a Fire Babe and I made it, I'm like, I can't wait for Chris to hear this. Because Chris is such an OG, it's like, and I'm still like, as much as people feel like, yeah, like big storms, whatever, I'm still like really happy to hear what a Chris Martin legend, like flipping icon, would think of my album.
Of course.
Like, just on like a kind of, even on a Young G one of like, yo, Chris, man, like, you like it, like, I hope you like it. Like, yo, Chris, I've done something sick. Like, you know, when you've done something sick and you want to show someone that. Like. So yeah, like, I'm sure he'll hit me. Like, he hit me about Fire Babe and Hide and Seek and said, like, they're really beautiful songs that resonate. So yeah, man, I'm just happy people are feeling it, man. Yeah.
We're enjoying.
Amen.
Do you know what else I'm enjoying? How much that you are back on social media. I've missed Stormzy on Instagram and Twitter. The gems that you have given us already since your return.
I know.
Taylor
I know.
Swift selfies, Insta lives, even the passing wind.
Yes, the passing wind, yes.
That was my one thing, you know. I said he better not pass wind.
Nah. Do you know, that's reserved for Asher and Mel and
the team,
Bianca.
The team.
Yeah, that's for them.
Have you missed interacting and sharing stuff with your fans on there?
Yeah, I've missed like, and I always say it because like I feel like I've got like, and I always say like my people, like, so even like when I perform, like when I go on tour or I do an album signing or like I got my people, and I can't explain it. Like I don't even say like my fans or my support. I was like my people, like in terms of they just mad hear me, they feel me, man, and they hear me and they see me and they understand me, like, and like I miss them in that sense. I remember I was in White City probably a couple months before the album dropped, and I saw two girls, like, big up these girls wherever they are, like, they might remember, and they said to me, and I was walking, and I might have been a bit lit, like, I'm with the Mandem, and they saw me, and they was like, oh my God, and I was like, yo, what's going on? There was Stormzy. I was like, yo, and then they just stopped, and they were like, are you okay? And I was like, yeah, I'm blessed, how are you, like? They were like, no, how are you? Like, are you okay? Aww. I was like, yeah, no, I'm good. Like, I'm chilling. I'm with them. Like, we're lit. Like, it's cool. Like, and they were like, no, like, we miss you. Like, how have you been? Like, and that made me like, I was like, yo, you like, I'm good. But I clocked this. I had such a presence on social media.
So much.
That me not being there made like people like, yo, where you at?
Yeah,
and I'm like,
right.
I'm here, man. Yeah. I'm here. Like, and I've always said like, I've done an Insta live a few weeks ago, and I always say like, yo, you lot are my people. I love you. I'm here in spirit, but just for like peace of mind and just for the life and the man that I got to be, I can't be here. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Without doing a TED talk on the reasons around it, it's like, I just can't be here, innit? So, but I love you lot and you lot are my people. And I always say, if you see me on the roads, you know what I mean? Salute, like, hug it out, we talk, like, but yeah, man. I have missed it, like, and even the interactions, being back on social and feeling people's energy, it's love, man, and I love them. And yeah, my people.
You're like everyone's bestie.
Yeah.
Like, when I watch you, I just like, want to come to the yard and party.
Man. Yeah, man.
And also, it's like, I overstand that, like, who I am in the world and what I've achieved and who I've become and what I've managed to, yeah, just everything that comes with being me is down to these people, like. I'm not even on the cliche one of like, big up the fans, man, and big thank you for buying the album. It's not even that. It's like, I've got one of those careers, like, and not everyone's got that type of career. Some people's careers like a different type, but I've got one of those careers who my thing's proper, like, I've been championed by people in it. So, And that's real life people. It's not robots. It's like real life humans who have championed me and just encouraged me and built me up. So I feel mad close to them and like, yo, man, I'm here. I love you for life. Like, but
special.
Man.
One in the background, obviously you can't see, you can hear, but the World Cup is playing.
Yes.
Ghana are on the screen. The World Cup is happening right now. Yes. I saw that you weren't happy about them losing against Portugal. You actually tweeted KMFT, and I can't say the national
word. Yeah, that's all I said.
Do it, Henry. Do it again.
I can't. I don't have enough.
Do it again. There you go. Are you still backing them?
I'm backing them. I'm backing them. Please,
Juls,
man.
What about you? You're also from Ghana. How do you feel?
Mate.
that's it right there, isn't it, mate?
Mate.
Backing them always.
Always, but come on. Techie, man. Please, man. Please.
Juls, you said that this was the most exciting World Cup, right? You tweeted something.
Yeah, like.
Is that what you think?
I think so,
you know.
I don't know about that.
I think a winter
World Cup is a bit mad to me.
No, I'm even. I was even looking at it from like some of the results, like some shockers, you know, Belgium losing. Yeah. To certain, that's
I'm
what
saying
I think,
yeah, like yeah. I've been following. I watched one England game. Didn't we lose?
She called it boring. No, it was a draw.
I didn't say that. I said that off air. So let's bring it back to Murky FC, because I know that it's an off-pitch initiative. But if you could put your own squad together with artists, some of your favourites, who would be in the lineup? How many people are in the football squad?
11. Ooh,
I can tell you who won't be in the lineup. This man right here.
No, I'm screaming.
What?
Juls is so dead. Oh my god. We play football at OC Island, I remember, writing the album. Juls played barefoot and he was dead.
Of course.
He backed off his shoes and his socks and he was so dead.
Do you know where it was? Do you know where it was? Do you know where it was?
Back in,
do you know it was? I was so focused on the sessions and stuff.
Yeah. Hey.
So I was trying to make sure that I was getting the right music.
Okay,
so
got ya.
My real skill was not there.
Maybe you could just go in.
Why do you turn about the penalty though?
Did you score? Did he score?
Zeb,
I don't think he scored. Bro, he didn't score. Bro,
yes,
did he score?
Did. Yes.
Juls, I don't think you scored, bro.
Yes, I did, bro.
Did he score against
bro.
Me?
I won the game for us.
Is it? Oh, go on. Come on, Ghana.
Ghana's just scored.
Come
I told
on, Ghana.
You, everyone. It's in the background.
Come on, Ghana.
It's in the background.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow. Who are they playing?
South Korea.
South Korea.
Come on, man.
But yeah,
come on, my boys,
that
man.
was just a bad day.
So who's in the squad? We know Juls.
Okay, so Juls
squad.
Ain't in the squad at all. He's far away from the squad.
Sub.
Dave.
Don't kill me.
Dave's cold.
Okay. Yeah, he's got his own. Has he not got a team? Was he not posting about?
And no, he's
team?
On a ban. Apparently, he said
he's
on a 14-game ban.
That's
which I find mad funny. Though.
Yeah,
he's on because. Do you know what you got to do to get banned for 14 games? That's a mad ban.
You must have done a mad ban.
So Dave, if he can not get banned and tone it down. who else will be in my team? Wretch. Rich is apparently cold.
Avelino is supposed to be good.
Yeah. Okay. This is my thing with Av. Av is cold. Go. Av is cold, isn't it? Like, I'm not gonna. That's my brother. Av is cold, but what's it? He's got. I don't know, man. Av's just. He's. Do you know what it is with Av? He's way better than he looks. I'll give him that. He's not that cold,
not really,
but he's colder
I've seen
than he looks.
Play.
And
I've seen it was some good. Things. I feel like Av is up there.
He's good. But do you know what it is with Av? I hate to give it to him. You know what I mean?
You know he's good.
Yeah, I hate to give it to him. I hate to give it to him. Who else?
Give me one final.
I'll give you one final person. Who's left at football, man?
What about a woman? Any girls? Any girls play? Wouldn't be me.
Maybe my sister.
Okay.
Rachel.
Rachel
can kick ball. Yeah, she can kick ball.
There you go.
Yeah.
I feel like we can't not talk about the album without mentioning the recently announced This Is What We Mean Day in conjunction with All Points East Festival. And you're like taking over a whole day.
Yes,
right?
I am. Yes.
Do you know who's going to be on that lineup?
We're drafting up lineups, but there's one act that I really want, but I don't think I should say it.
Why? We're friends now. Come on.
I don't know.
All right, give me a clue and let me guess. I love a game.
Oh, okay. What's a good clue to give you?
British?
British, yes.
Male or female?
Female.
Okay.
Tall or short?
Mixture.
Oh! Mixture, okay, she's like 5'6". Blonde hair, dark hair?
Dark hair.
Braids?
Sometimes.
Thames? Oh, no, she's not
Thames
British.
Thames ain't British. I would love to have Thames.
I'm sweating. Sometimes she has braids.
No.
Little Sims.
I was going
to
say.
I would love to have Sims.
Because she's got locks.
I would love to. Listen, I would love to have all these locks. Artists. But there's,
I can't get it.
No, you wait. I don't think you would get it.
I can't get it.
Medium build.
Medium height.
Sometimes braids.
Sometimes braids.
There's not that many of us, really.
Neo.
I would love to have Neo as well.
All right, we're not going to get it. We're not going to get it. I'm just going to keep
shouting out names randomly. Yeah,
I'm going to say we're looking forward to it.
Yes, please.
Shall I wait our tickets in the post?
Yes, they are coming. Yeah, there you VIP go. Section.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. In all seriousness, though, Stormzy, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me, guys, man. Thank you so much.
This is what I mean. The album is out now. Juls, Henrie, my family. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys, man. God bless.
Thank you. Bye now.